This is CNN.
You're looking at live pictures of protests tonight outside of JFK Airport. This is new legal filings show dozens and dozens of people are being held inside of New York's JFK Airport, detained under President Trump's executive order banning citizens from seven Muslim-majority countries from entering the United States. This hour, attorneys from the ACLU are in federal court in Brooklyn asking for a nationwide stay on this travel ban. These protests, not just here in New York, they are across the country, Denver, Washington, Chicago, and more. These are the seven countries singled out in the travel ban: Iran, Iraq, Syria, Libya, Sudan, Yemen, and Somalia. Let's debate it. Jeffrey Lord is back with me, CNN political commentator and a former advisor to President Reagan, and Anousheh Hussain, a Muslim-American journalist and editor-in-chief of Anousheh'sPoint.com. Thank you both for being here tonight. Jeffrey, let me begin
Hello,
with you.
Hello, again.
Good to have you here. Let me begin with you. Let's just look at the totality of who is banned when we talk about this, specifically Syrian refugees, given the civil war. Take a look at this. These are two well-known, disturbing images. One of Aylan Kurdi, that young toddler who died washed up on the Turkish beach after his family fled Syria. And then on the other side of your screen is Omran Dakhnish. His family's home in Aleppo was bombed. He lost family members. There he sits, bloodied in an ambulance. These are victims of the civil war in Syria. These are victims who will not be allowed in this country. Do you believe that these children could terrorize the United States?
Poppy, this is an excellent question. I want to hold up to you a headline from the New York Times in 2012, September 10th of 2012. And the headline is, "The deafness before the storm. The Bush White House was deaf to 9/11 warnings." And what this article says is that George W. Bush was completely negligent, that he was warned repeatedly that there could be attacks on the United States by al-Qaeda. He didn't pay attention to them. He was negligent, and thousands of people died as a result. Now, I just want to say President Trump is a profile and courage on this, because if, let's just go back to
Jeffrey
pre-9/11.
Jeffrey Lord, it was not my question to you.
Yes, it was, Poppy. You're asking me about these people. I'm saying, what about
all
those
you about the children
on 9/11? And if George W. Bush had instituted the measures that Donald Trump is instituting now, 9/11, A, would never have happened, and according to the critic, and B, you would have had all these complaints from people exactly as you're complaining now, that they're being kept out of the United States and this is terrible, et cetera. In other words, you're damned if you do and damned if you don't. And I can't tell you how much I respect President Trump for doing this, because
so
he's going to get
argument,
it in the
on
neck.
On your argument, Jeffrey Lord, two points that I'd like your response to. One, if that is the argument you're making, then why does this ban not include any of the four countries where the 9/11 hijackers came from? Saudi Arabia, the UAE, Lebanon,
again,
and Egypt. And let me ask you the other part of that question. The other key part of all of this is, why is it that you cannot point to, nor the Trump administration can point to, a single terror attack carried out by a Syrian refugee in the United States?
Poppy, the world is a very small place. People who came into France in a mass of Syrian refugees did in fact kill 130 French people.
And Jeffrey Lord, they did not go through the two-year vetting process. They did not go through the two-year vetting process that Syrian refugees go through in the United States. So you cannot compare the two.
Poppy, this system is a mess. It is a mess. As you pointed out in an earlier segment, someone from Pakistan who came in through, you know, had a Saudi visa, came into this country on a K-1 fiancé visa and killed 14 people. Poppy, you should not have to go to a Christmas party and wind up dead.
Guess what, Jeffrey Lord? Pakistan and Saudi Arabia aren't included in this ban either.
Anousheh, your take.
President Trump has said, hold on, I got to get Anousheh in here. President Trump has said, this is not a Muslim ban. In no way, shape, or form is it. And I should note, this does not include other Muslim-majority nations like Turkey, like Saudi Arabia, like Indonesia. What's your reaction?
My reaction, Poppy, is that I wish I could describe to you the fear and the anxiety of being an American Muslim right now. This ban is completely illegal, it's unconstitutional, and as you pointed out, the main countries where the terrorist attacks have been carried out in the U.S., such as Pakistan, such as Saudi Arabia, are not even on this list. This ban achieves nothing but fear. It feeds nothing but Islamophobia. It's tearing apart U.S. families as we speak. And as someone who has been through the U.S. immigration system, let me tell you, it's not a cakewalk. You are vetted for months, even years, just to get a tourist visa. I went from a student visa to an H-1B to a green card to now I'm a U.S. citizen. And it takes years. I cannot imagine what these people are going through, being turned away, having their visas deemed null and void at the border. This is not what America is about, and it's a boon to ISIS.
Let me read you. Hold on, Jeffrey. I want you to respond to this. Republican U.S. Senator Ben Sasse, also a member of the Senate Armed Services Committee, issued this statement tonight, which reads in part, quote, "While not technically a Muslim ban, this order is too broad. If we send a signal to the Middle East that the U.S. sees all Muslims as jihadis, the terrorist recruiters win by telling kids that America is banning Muslims and that this is America versus one religion." Your response to that from your fellow Republican, Senator Ben Sasse. Yeah.
Right, who was never a Trump supporter to begin with. Let me just say, Rudy Giuliani, when he was the U.S. attorney, went after the mafia. He was Italian, they were Italian. He wasn't looking for Jewish guys in Montana. He was looking at the Italian American community. If you're prosecuting the IRA, you go into in America, you go into Irish American communities in America. I mean, there is nothing unusual about this. I mean, the U.S. government has gone after Protestants, Jews, Muslims, when they thought they were in violation or could be in violation of government policy.
Jeffrey Lord, the U.S. also interned Japanese Americans, 120,000 of them. Was that right?
Good point. Of course not, Poppy. That was racist and illegal and unconstitutional.
This is racist and illegal and unconstitutional, Jeffrey. This ban is just the same. This Muslim ban is just as racist, just as unconstitutional.
So let me see if I understand this. So in other words, you think that George W. Bush should have instituted this kind of ban before 9/11 to prevent it?
I'm against this ban, period. It's illegal and un-American, Jeffrey.
We have to
leave
it there.
All right, so we should just sit back, attacked, and let 3,000 people be killed.
The 9/11 hijackers came from four countries that are not included in this ban. I will have you both back. I'd like you to join me tomorrow night because I'm out of time tonight. We'll be right back.
Thank you, Poppy.